hard does he hit?
Yeah, it's hard. I would say he probably hits probably right about 168 pounders level. Hits real hard. I mean, he commits to his shots, really plants his feet, and digs in. He's got tremendous core strength, and he's a really good athlete. You know, he's a great athlete. So I think the diversity in his training and stuff helps him with that too. But punches hard.
Is that something you're born with, or can any person develop power like that?
I think you're probably born with it for the most part. I think you can increase your power a little bit through some stuff that you do, but by no means is it a secret to how to get it. I think most guys are born with it. And he punches hard. You know, some guys, you'll hear him say, guy's got heavy hands. I wouldn't say necessarily he's like a heavy-handed puncher, but he punches very hard. It's a little bit of a different feel on the mitts, but he's one of the hardest punchers, probably below 175 pounds that I've ever worked with.
As a strength and conditioning trainer, you work with a fight. You're also a boxing trainer and an MMA trainer, but you have Victor getting prepared for a fight, almost peaks, 2 weeks before the fight, there's an injury, the fight's off. And as a human being, you're disappointed. You're like, oh, I put in all this work. How do you get him back to the point where, okay, let's just keep going?
With Vic, it wasn't really hard. I mean, he was very disappointed that the fight got canceled, but he stays in such good shape in between fights that it wasn't hard to get him motivated. Yeah, we kicked him out of the gym for about 10, 12 days, and then he was right back in. So he called me, you know, 4 days after the Mayweather fight, and we did pads in the gym. So
Is Rodella going to be in the gym more, sparring, working out?
Hopefully. He's been down getting Mr. Senchenko ready for the Paulie Malignaggi fight. But I think that's about all he's been doing right now. He's helping me. He's co-training a couple people with me right now. So hopefully we can get the fire lit under his ass again pretty soon.
Let's speak of that Paulie Malignaggi-Senchenko fight. What do you think about it?
I have no idea. You know, I mean, there's so many different ways that could happen. I could see Senchenko's constant pressure being too much. I could see Paulie's speed and experience just totally befuddling him. I could see it being a close fight, and there's no way you're going to win a close fight in the Ukraine. So, you know, there's a couple different ways that could turn out. I mean, Paulie's real durable. I don't think Senchenko's going to stop him. And Paulie's not a real big hitter, so he's probably not going to stop Senchenko. So it's going to be an interesting fight.
There you have it, Hoss the Boss. Very, very talented trainer, also strength and conditioning expert. Stay tuned for more from the Staples Center, where Andre Brito and Victor Ortiz will mix it June 23rd. Tickets start at $50. I'm Eli Sekbak reporting.